really know how they look on the other two. So
I say I'm excited to see.
Actually, that's false. They did play one high rise.
Okay.
And it did not go well. So hopefully that's what they're playing today. So hopefully they work on that and get that going. It does look like we're getting in. Yes, we are. Yes, we're loading into hard point. All right, and we do have good side. So on this side, maybe we don't. We'll find out. I don't know which side we're on. Okay, we are on the bad side. So the good side is security, because they spawn literally right next to the point, as you can see.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm interested to see what we decide to try to break this. They're actually very off the bat. We're just looking to clear this hall and then trying to pinch the site, but obviously that's difficult, as you can see. It's just so easy to hold this. So really what we're trying to do is just maintain spawns, but also keeping St. Clair on their toes. Actually, we did spawn out, so maybe we pinch this and try to get in. Looks like Airstrike's got taken down, so Mikey's just going to rotate. They don't want to lose these spawns because they need to get at least some back.
Yeah, absolutely. Good pick off from Mikey here, actually. Getting that strike there.
Yeah, it's so hard to transition this map. There's just so many sight lines, so many rat corners, that it's kind of hard to maintain any kind of control. Didn't even get a point off that sucks.
Yeah.
But yeah, you can see they have a cross on that hallway, and then they don't have any planes, so maybe we'll be able to put space there. But missing piece is taken down right off the bat.
Yeah, that top AC control is really hurting Fares here.
Yeah, it's just such a good spot, you know. And I think we're just gonna try and maintain where we are. And it doesn't. Oh, and we did get a pick, so maybe we try to rotate in.
Oh, okay.
They do have someone in play, so maybe not. Otto's gonna get picked up random, but he's gonna get traded out. Airstrike's trying to get in, but he just couldn't get anything going. He's gonna hold this choke, but he's gonna get taken down. You can see towards new. That's brutal. I don't know how bullets don't go through couches, but I guess that is what it is. Mikey's gonna be able to take out his TV, try to get a little bit more of a foothold on the site. And that is gonna be the name of the game. Can they take the guy off the heady? And I don't know if they're gonna be able to. It's just such a hard fight to take. This isn't looking too good for Ferris, but you know, this is the number two seed. Number two seed. So, I mean, they knew going into it that it was gonna be a difficult game.
Yeah, I do like so far seeing Ferris's ability to take fights together, at least yes. Showing that their teamwork is still there, even when the game is looking difficult.
Yeah. Yeah, and Priestley is just going insane with the Renetti, so. And they're able to transition that. I can't say enough that this St. Clair team is the number two seed there. They're just looking like a well-oiled machine right now.
Oh, yeah.
As Slayer takes out Otto. Mikey is going to get traded out to get that kill. Airstrike gets taken down, trying to contest the point.
Positives here for Ferris is I like their looks when it comes to trades.
Yes.
They're always looking to get that trade off. Mikey getting one on point here, I think, will be that go button for him.
Yeah. They're just not able to get any space on this. They're just getting suffocated every time, and it's kind of hard to break into the hill when you're just getting suffocated from all angles.
Yeah. Yeah, the crossfires from St. Clair are really killer right now.
Looks like Otto's just going to try and hold this spawn and get his kill, yeah? Isn't going to be able to read the next one, but should get traded out, missing piece. Is going to get traded with Matt Priestley, so they are going to get to the next point. And this is looking dire for the Bulldogs right now. Good kill from Airstrike, trying to open up the site. He just can't see his head, and that's a nasty head punch.
Oh, yeah.
It looks like he's taking down. And Sinclair can win off of this, so that is something to consider. See if we can break into this point, but it is looking dire for sure.
The crossfires from AC and Plane are just absolutely brutal right now.
Yeah, I mean, they are completely locking down everything. Good kill from Airstrike. If there's anything to take from this game, this gun still does look high despite the scoreline, and that's going to be the game.
Yeah.
I mean, they knew going into this is going to be an uphill battle, so.
Yeah. Like I said, the trades are looking good from them, at least. A lot of times when someone on contract can find there's somebody else there to pick it up, and to take that one for one, it's just really hard on hard point. Because then you're in that 3v3, and it still becomes hard to take that point.
And you can see St. Clair, it's all even. They're evenly distributing everything. I mean, that was just all around team effort.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely.
I believe it goes to Skid Row S&D after this. So, okay. I don't know how much time is going to be in between, and we can take a quick break if you want. It's up to you. Continue talking.
I think that. Our playstyle should fit better in Search and Destroy.
Yeah, I think so too.
Playing together, playing those trades, and I think being able to slow the game down, I think it should be beneficial to this Ferris team.
And this is a map we looked good on, so I'm hoping that translates, but we will see. This is a lot less of like, just complete chaos. It's more refined and meticulous, so maybe we'll perform better in that, but we'll have to see. Other Ferris news, as many know, CEGCon's coming up next week, and
yes,
I believe you're going as well.
I am.
Yeah, so that'll be exciting. It's, I believe, 120-person LAN that the Computer Enthusiast Group puts on, and I know I'm going, and a few people from the COD team are going as well, so it'll be interesting to see how that turns out. It's a great event every year.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, so. I can't wait for it. I know... Quite a few people from the Overwatch team are going, as well as just general staff around here.
Mm-hmm.
So it should be a lot of fun.
Yeah. I guess we're just going to wait for the next game. Is there anything else you got, or do you want me to just keep talking? Or
I don't think I have anything. I'm looking for, because I know in the short time that I did play COD, Search and Destroy was my favorite, because... It does feel like that more refined, slow map pushes.
Yeah.
So I think that will benefit us, because I noticed a lot on that terminal. They'd have like three people on crossfires.
Yeah.
St. Clair would. And then they'd have one on flank.
Yep.
And then, so I think on search, we'll be able to punish that a lot more.
Yeah.
I'm hoping that that'll be a better look for us.
I will say Skid Row, so we did play that today against St. Ambrose.
Mm-hmm.
I am interested to see how St. Clair runs their defense, because with St. Ambrose, we were able to just take tunnel immediately and then just bang off of that.
Yeah.
And Missing Piece will just stay on his own, and I don't think we're going to be able to do that against St. Clair, because if he gets taken down, boom, you're down 4-3 already, and it's an uphill battle more than it already is. So I'm looking for us to be a little bit more tight-knit when we do our pushes and maybe trying to bait out a little more of a response from St. Clair before making any decisions on how we do during rounds, especially attacking rounds.
Yeah.
And for defense, I think it's just more of holding your ground and not like getting baited out on certain actions that St. Clair is going to do.
Mm-hmm.
You don't want to over... rotate, especially in a map like Skid Row, because it's so easy to take space.
Okay.
So I'm interested to see how we do that.
Okay. Say, because I know trying to translate knowledge from game to game here.
Yeah.
In Overwatch, your small retreats, basically, especially when you see people, especially when you see the other team using cooldowns or using abilities and stuff.
Yeah.
Small retreat there, gather yourselves, stabilize, and then re-pushing when you know they don't have those anymore. Does that translate well over into COD?
Yeah, I would say so. You didn't really see it much in that hard point, but that is something that does happen. You kind of just wait for your teammates so you don't get staggered, especially on pushes. And you kind of just play together.
Yeah.
But, I mean, it looked rough right off the bat, which comes with playing the two seed. So
yeah.
The only one better than that is Northwood, and we all know what Northwood's capable of. So.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah. I think we're just kind of waiting on the S&D start. So I don't really have anything else to say. So I guess we'll just put a quick bait. We might be back in 5 seconds. We might be back in a couple minutes. I don't know. So we'll see. We're still here. I don't know what's going on, but maybe we're going in. I don't know.
Unsure.
I don't know. I don't have anything else to say, so I don't know what to do. so I guess we'll just sit here and maybe we're going in.
Look.
Ferris State College, an attitude of success that started in the mind of one great man, Woodbridge N. Ferris. A former governor of Michigan and United States Senator, Ferris founded the institution 100 years ago. His intent was to provide a practical education for any person with the motivation and potential to benefit. Initially known as the Ferris Industrial School, it became the Ferris Institute at the turn of the century. In 1950, Ferris became a state college with a growing national recognition for its dedication to educational success. However, tragedy struck as fire swept through the college, consuming most of its beautiful campus and its past. But its spirit could not be quelled. From the ashes rose a new and greater commitment to success, growing at an unprecedented rate. Still located where it was founded 100 years ago in the scenic Muskegon River Valley, Ferris now boasts a new campus accommodating its over 100 career-oriented programs. Ferris's most popular school is the School of Business, boasting a wide variety of programs in business and management fields. Established nearly a century ago, Ferris's School of Pharmacy remains one of the most prestigious pharmacy schools in the Midwest. More than half of all practicing pharmacists in Michigan hail from Ferris. The newest addition to Ferris is the College of Optometry, the only such school in Michigan and one of 14 in the nation. Ferris's place at the forefront of technical education is maintained by the Schools of Education and Technology. Career-oriented hands-on training in all of Ferris's programs produce an overall job placement rate of over 90%. This combined with student dedication has made success a tradition at Ferris for over 100 years. The 1984 centennial celebration saw the arrival of a new Ferris State College president, J. William Winrick. His plan is to renew the commitment to practical education that Woodbridge N. Ferris made over a century ago.
Ferris will maintain its distinctive mission of training people for careers, for professions, occupations, that it does so well. And the difference will be primarily in these new occupations, new technologies. As society and technology changes, we're going to change to respond to that. The basic mission won't change at all.
Another new face is head football coach Dan Underwood. He comes fresh from shining successes as defensive assistant for Central Michigan, Michigan State, and most recently, Arizona State, where he helped coach the defensive team to the number one spot in the nation.
Really, Dan Underwood is a superb coach. He's a great guy, great human being. He's starting new first year as I am at the college. He's bringing in his own system, his own people, his own assistants. He's educating and training players in the way he wants them to do. This year we've had a heavily freshman team, got kids who are coming in for the first time with Dan. And I'm really excited about what he's doing and can do.
Dan Underwood's goal.
We're back. Sorry for for the delayed start in our comms. Looks like we are hot off the restart. So looks like Brandon took down Airstrike. I wasn't able to see what happened right off the bat, but
Priestley took out Missing Piece.
Okay,
I did see that much as well.
So it does look like we're trying to bang out this A point, but they're getting flanked right now, and that's gonna be the end of the round.
Yeah, that's. I didn't see exactly who was flanking them.
Yeah.
At that last.
It was Brandon.
It was Brandon. Yep. Because that was also something.
Very nice play too.
Oh, absolutely. Catching them off guard, but that was something that was hard to punish in that terminal hard point game. Was that one flanker coming around and causing havoc.
All right. Well, now we're moving the defense to this. We'll be able to see what our defense is going to look like for this. I'd imagine it's not going to deviate much from St. Ambrose defense, but a little bit of lag there. but yeah, I think this will just kind of stay the same, but it does look like they're going. Yeah. And Otto's going to be able to get the trade, but he is going to get taken down by KB. KB's got two on the round. It does look like they're looking at pushing this. Mikey's going to look. He did spot him. He's going to get shots down, so that's good. Oh, and he's going to get shot through the wall, and he knows it. Oh, that was just a brutal way for that to go.
Absolutely. Missing Piece in this 1v3.
Oh, and he's going to get melee'd. And that is a tough round for the Bulldogs. And it looks like the momentum from St. Clair is just going to continue.
Absolutely.
I mean, I was talking to them. They knew this was going to be difficult, so.
Yeah.
St. Clair is always one of the top teams every year. They go to the LAN every year for the finals. So, I mean, you know what you're signing up for when you have to play them.
Absolutely. Bright points, though. It was Otto getting the trade last round.
Yes.
So it wasn't flawless round from St. Clair. There are mistakes there that we can punish.
Yes. It does look like we're... We are making it seem like we're trying to push out, but we are still tunnel. So that's a good fake from the Bulldogs. But it does look like they're heavily pushing out. And Missing Piece should get one. He's going to get two. He is going to get two.
Good.
That's a huge
play
for Missing Piece. Great bait out by Mikey there to make the St. Clair push out. And good execution.
Yeah, that overconfidence from St. Clair really getting punished by Missing Piece. What a wonderful bait and what way to get him out in the open like that.
Yeah. So we do have full control of their spawn, so I'm looking to see how they decide to push this out. One, I believe. Oh, Otto is going to take out Priestley, and we are going to plant the bomb, so it's a 1v3. As KB takes down Missing Piece, but they know where he is. And he's low, but he's not low enough. We are just kind of just holding it. KB's going to peek outside fire. And he is going to take down Otto, but he is low. So look to see Airstrike make an adjustment to see. And KB just flies out. I can't believe it. He just flied out. He didn't care. And Mikey's going to take Mikey's celebrating getting a round win. Yippee!
That was great play, though. It was
yes.
baiting that overconfidence, getting him into that 4v2,
yep.
and then taking him out one by one after that.
Yep. I don't know if they're going to continue doing that because Sinclair might make adjustments to not push things, but if we could keep exploiting their overconfidence, that'd be a good way to exploit them and try and get some more round wins.
Mikey, making sure to have some fun in this game
yes.
as well.
And he's just going to sit in the same spot behind the box. Maybe push out. There is two of them there. It's him and Missing Piece, so... Oh, what is, who is that? A six? And Slaya's just going to push out, and St. Clair's already got the bomb down.
Yeah.
So that's already putting a timer on the Bulldogs. Should get a tick with that. Oh, he's right below him! Oh, and he just didn't know he was there? A brutal way to go down. Oh, and he's going to get taken down, KB. Auto last alive. He's going to get a stick.
Oh, good. Auto takes
out Enslayer. I think he knows the flank's coming, but he can't do anything about it.
Yeah.
He's going to get assassinated. That's messed up, but it is what it is.
Yep. Those 1v4s are just hard
so hard. So difficult.
Yeah.
I knew as soon as he didn't shoot him right off the bed, he was gonna take him down. He was going to do the takedown.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, he stole it from him.
Oh, wow.
That's kind of messed up. It is what it is.
It is what it is.
That's kind of messed up. I wouldn't do that to my teammate. That's all I know.
Neither would I.
Oh. So.
That was that hyper aggression that St. Clair has been showing,
yes.
where they just sprint into sight, instantly take control of it, and get planted down within. I mean, that was like within the first 30 seconds of the round.
Yeah, I mean, and it was flawless, too. I mean, they perfectly hit that. Brandt's going to get auto. Is going to get traded out by Airstrike, though. They do know Enslayer is there now, so interesting to see what they do there. He's gonna get flanked. No one read him. That was just a complete collapse by St. Clair onto the Bulldogs.
Yeah.
And they take a 4-1 lead.
Just that flanker being able to get right in there. This is where my lack of COD knowledge comes in, because I'm not sure how Ferris could adjust here.
I mean, I don't know either. I'm going to be honest. I mean, they're kind of just buying time and waiting to see if Sinclair makes a move, but when they make a move, it's all of them. It's not just one or two.
Yeah.
And you can see Sinclair's going to try and take a full hit through tunnel, and they're going to take down Airstrike. They're probably going to move out towards Apps. Yeah, they're just taking Apps. And 8 is moving behind 4. He's going to take him out, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know how he slipped through the defense of the Bulldogs, but he did.
Otto's
going to take out Brandon. Mikey's trying to move through P3. Is he going to do this?
He does.
And he's going to take out Enslayer. So it's down to the duo. Otto, Mikey, can they do it?
They've done it before.
7. Presley pushing out. Trying to flank, he's gonna be flanked. Mikey's probably gonna go down here. It's all down to Otto.
Was a good attempt from the duo.
What was that? Yeah, it was a good try. And they are down 5-1. Tough looks for the Bulldogs.
Down, but not out.
Yes.
I think that's the one thing to always remember.
One takeaway from this, they did get a point, which they didn't get one in hard point. So that is something to take away from it.
Absolutely, yeah.
I think this only highlights how difficult an opponent St. Clair is. I'm pretty sure they're all, like, iridescent players.
Yeah.
Top 250, so I'm pretty sure iridescent. So, yeah, that only just speaks to how good this is. We are just banging it out through DVD. They just don't care. This is a good idea because I don't think they expected it. So
yeah, and again that trading
see,
mentality
of
Ferris.
Taking a flank wide. KB is going to take down Missing Piece, and Otto's just going to go on a route. They do know he's there though. They know.
He does sneak through, though.
Yes. He's just... he does not know what to do. I mean, what are you going to do? Oh, and he's going to get shot up. You can see five, maybe. He's going to go around.
Yeah.
So maybe a little bit of trickery out of auto there. Try and make him push out.
Yeah, just trying to bait out that aggression.
Five's going to stay mid. Seven's trying to sniff out auto, but auto's already gone.
There's one. Oh.
And that will be the game, I believe. Right, that was six?
Yep, I believe that
was
six.
And that will be the game. 6-1. St. Clair Saints take down Ferris State in the S&D.
But I think the important thing is to remember, right, it's that search game wasn't – the score looks like it was a domination.
Yes.
But a lot of those rounds were close. A lot of them came down
auto
to –
auto 6 and 7.
Ooh.
This is the highlight of the team. But, yeah, well, as you can see, it just still
– yeah.
Just overwhelming might from the St. Clair Saints, so –
yeah, because I think if a couple of those rounds went differently, right, we'd still be in lobby. We'd be looking at that like 3-5, and it'd be a much winnable game.
Oh, okay. I was like, are we still in? We went to BRB. But, yeah, tough loss for the Bulldogs. But, I mean, there's not really much to say there. I mean, it was kind of just, it is what it is. You got to look at the next, which I believe, I'll check real quick. I think it's Karachi. Yes. No, it is High Rise. Control. So
yes.
Didn't look too good for them Wednesday. I'm hoping they are able to shore up and get that going, but we will have to see. Until then, I believe the Bulldogs are on a break, so we will as well. So we'll see you on the other side of this break.
Four freshmen this last fall. And we had at one time, we had as many as 14 starred for us. So I think next year and the years to come, you're going to see freshmen and sophomores as we grow up play. So I think it's a great opportunity for a freshman to come in and play early.
Coaching staff here at Ferris is great. We had a good coaching staff the last 3 years I've been here, but for my senior year, we had a new staff come in. Dan Underwood came in from Arizona State and brought along an excellent staff with him. I think the next 3 years, the team will improve a lot, and it's a young team, and they brought in 45 recruits, and between those guys, I think they're going to have a real football dynasty in the next 3 years.
The programs are fine also. It's a variety of programs that you can go into. They have something for everyone.
I think the coaching staff is great. All the new coaches came in, brought a lot of freshmen in, and let everybody see what they can do, and told all the players that all the jobs was open.
What I like most about Ferris is that you're an individual up here and people understand you, they know you, and you're not treated like just another number like you would be at another school possibility. And it's just, you're treated as one, an individual.
I really like the coaching staff. They're really nice. They're young coaching staff, and I think they'll take us to the championship.
What I like most about Ferris is the campus life. There's a lot of activities on campus here at Ferris. You meet a lot of interesting people, and there's just a lot of things to do for you.
Our coaching staff is very enthusiastic, very excited. Always keep you pumped up and ready for the game. You're doing season and off season.
And it does look like we are back. I believe we're live. Can you?
Yes. Okay, we are live.
Mine just sounds kind of goofy, so. As you can see, Otto with the sniper. He's going to try and get a triple collat. We'll see.
Oh, he does get one. Just won.
That is a breaking GA, but it is what it is. He wanted to see if he could do it. And I thought it was pretty funny. So, yeah, here. off to an interesting start for the Bulldog. You can see Monkey's got a good chuckle out of it.
Sometimes that morale boost is just what you need.
And Otto's gonna get taken out on the spot. We are making some progress on B, but that is gonna get rocked out by the St. Clair fans. See if we can make a little bit more space. And Missing Piece is gonna take out KB. So good trade from Missing Piece. He's just looking for anything. Mike's gonna take out N Slaya. And we see they're trying to go towards A. Missing Piece is gonna get taken out by Kirby. Airstrike just unable to get that kill on Brandon. So we will see how they react. The Airstrike gets that kill on the onto Brandon. Mikey's gonna get one on Priestley, so we could see him move towards B. End Slayer. Pretty low off of after that fight. He's gonna push out, but Mikey didn't see him. So we are back on site. And that will be Bulldogs going down. Otto's trying to get to the top of the map. And I think they're just trying to have a little bit of fun here before this game's over. You see Mikey's just creeping out there. KB taking down Mikey. Missing Piece is going to get taken down Presley. And Slayer's going to get that trade, but Otto is going to trade out with Slayer. Otto gets taken out by Brandon, and Mikey will get one last kill before the end of the game, or end of the round. My bad.
Positives to take away from that round.
Six sniper kill.
Six sniper kill. Absolutely.
It did look like we were getting a lot more kills than previously thought. So
yeah.
That is a good sign. Obviously, they still lost, but nevertheless, still a decent amount of kills coming from the Bulldogs there. Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't think it looks that bad.
Not,
I mean,
not
much
at all.
Better than. He's going to go for it again.
Let's see. This is just a wait and see.
Do they? And he's just going to kill himself. And there's that. As you can see, I think they know it's going to be hard for them to come back in this game, so they're just trying to have a little bit more fun.
Oh, yeah.
Before their next match.
But lives, for the most part of that round, were close.
Yeah, they weren't as bad as I thought they were going to be. Just because, as you can see, St. Clair is just on a heater. I mean, they look like they know what to do.
Good trade from Mr. Beast.
Otto's just decided to bring all the GAs, so I'm interested to see if he gets yelled at for that, but we'll see. I mean, it is what it is.
Yeah.
They're just trying to have a little bit of fun, so. Good kill out of Airstrike Press. We got Mikey. Airstrike's going to get blown up to smithereens.
Oof.
And you can see Otto's starting to move. Oh, he's going for the tunnel, or for the roof. Is he going to get it, though? I do not know. I don't think he is not going to get there before the game runs out. And, oh, good trade. And they were able to stop progress at A. So, good moves from the Bulldogs. And they're not down by lives that much, only five.
Yeah, this is absolutely doable.
Mikey takes down Brandon and gets straight out by KB. And you see smiles on their face. They're just trying to have as much fun as possible, given their situation. That is a nasty spot from the
MPs.
That was very interesting. I've never seen that before.
Airstrike and Mikey both taking out one, though. Making this, keeping this game close.
I mean, despite them screwing around a bit, it's still closer than, I think, only down by four lives.
Yeah.
I mean, one team wiped in, you're right back in it. Oh,
Airstrike
with
a the
nasty
schmooves.
Two. Yeah. What about Ice Skates? And Slayer with his triple, and Presley gonna take down that, and that should be the round, I have a feeling. Maybe not, maybe I'm able to get on site, you never know.
May not be.
That's
Mikey gets
tick.
Presley.
Airstrike just trying to find any space to try and move on. And he is. He's gonna take down one, isn't gonna take down the other. And that looks like it will be the round. KB getting a triple there. And that will be that.
Still, the
lives were closer than I thought they would be. So that this isn't as bad as it seems.
Yeah,
we're down 2-0, but we are getting kills where they matter. So yeah, that is a highlight.
Yeah, because
going into the next game,
the kills are in lives are even closer than what they were last Wednesday.
Yes.
On control.
Yeah, it was a brutal look on Wednesday for
yeah.
sure.
So
Adrian,
against the number 2 seed, we're looking better than what we did before. That just shows the improvement this team has.
And a double.
He gets the 4.
And the sniper goes hard in the paint as he's able to get 4 there. That was they are just having an absolute laugh about that one. That was hilarious. And I think he's gonna type something in the chat. That was pretty funny. Yeah, I don't know what he's doing, but it's fine. Mikey on the point, trying to get some tick, but he isn't gonna get one. Airstrike just chilling in the back, and they are able to get. He is able to get that kill on Brandon. KB gets trade on missing piece. You can see Otto and Airstrike coming out. One of the St. Clair players are trying to get on top of the building, so that'll probably happen. As you see, life's looking a little grim for the Bulldogs, but
yeah.
I mean, after that, there's really not much to say after a quad feed in the with the sniper. So
yeah, that is Otto getting his highlight.
And Presley getting and he's just bringing out the.
Yeah.
And they're just having
yep.
It's all fun and games. I think they accepted that they weren't going to be able to pull this one out. It's fun to see them have a little bit of fun. Even though it didn't go their way.
Yep.
And as the second step now, it's going to be another win for St. Clair. And Ferris are going to have to play another game against, I think it's Wisconsin. Or somebody else. I don't remember who the other team was, but
okay.
Yeah. So yeah, that's gonna do it for that round, that map, that series. So I believe there's gonna be another little break. I think there's gonna be a. We're gonna have to end the stream because they need the info from the game. But
Okay.
We'll be right back with another game. I don't know who it's gonna be with, but we'll see, and we'll be back when that happens.
See you soon.
Freshman this last fall, and we had at one time we had as many as 14 starred for us. So I think next year and the years to come, you're going to see freshmen and sophomores as we grow up play. So I think it's a great opportunity for a freshman to come in and play early.
Coaching staff here at Ferris is great. We had a good coaching staff the last 3 years I've been here, but for my senior year, we had a new staff come in. Dan Underwood came in from Arizona State and brought along an excellent staff with him. I think the next 3 years, the team will improve a lot, and it's a young team, and they brought in 45 recruits, and between those guys, I think they're going to have a real football dynasty in the next 3 years.
Programs are fine also, it's a variety of programs that you can go into, they have something for everyone.
I think the coaching staff is great. All the new coaches came in, brought a lot of freshmen in, and let everybody see what they can do, and told all the players that all the jobs was open.
I like most about Ferris is that you're an individual up here and people understand you, they know you, and you're not treated like just another number like you would be at another school possibility. And it's just, you're treated as one, an individual.
I really like the coaching staff. They're really nice. They're young coaching staff, and I think they'll take us to the championship.
What I like most about Ferris is the campus life. There's a lot of activities on campus here at Ferris. You meet a lot of interesting people, and there's just a lot of things to do for you.
Our coaching staff is very enthusiastic, very excited. Always keep you pumped up and ready for the game, even during season and off season.
To help build the special skills required to create a winning team, Dan Underwood brought in his own coaching assistants. Underwood believes that you win on defense. He also knows that you can't win without a good blend of running and throwing. And you can't forget the fan support. Football is an important part of Ferris State College. Athletes learn about teamwork, personal commitment, and they all reach for that common goal, success. Industry, opportunity, education. The ideas upon which Woodbridge and Ferris founded the institution, and 100 years later, are still the driving force behind Ferris's success, not only in the classroom, but out on the field. Ferris State College, an attitude of success that started in the mind of one great man, Woodbridge N. Ferris. A former governor of Michigan and United States Senator, Ferris founded the institution 100 years ago. His intent was to provide a practical education for any person with the motivation and potential to benefit. Initially known as the Ferris Industrial School, it became the Ferris Institute at the turn of the century. In 1950, Ferris became a state college with a growing national recognition for its dedication to educational success. However, tragedy struck as fire swept through the college, consuming most of its beautiful campus and its past. But its spirit could not be quelled. From the ashes rose a new and greater commitment to success, growing at an unprecedented rate. Still located where it was founded 100 years ago in the scenic Muskegon River Valley, Ferris now boasts a new campus accommodating its over 100 career-oriented programs. Ferris's most popular school is the School of Business, boasting a wide variety of programs in business and management fields. Established nearly a century ago, Ferris's School of Pharmacy remains one of the most prestigious pharmacy schools in the Midwest. More than half of all practicing pharmacists in Michigan hail from Ferris. The newest addition to Ferris is the College of Optometry, the only such school in Michigan and one of 14 in the nation. Ferris's place at the forefront of technical education is maintained by the Schools of Education and Technology. Career-oriented hands-on training in all of Ferris's programs produce an overall job placement rate of over 90%. This combined with student dedication has made success a tradition at Ferris for over 100 years. The 1984 centennial celebration saw the arrival of a new Ferris State College president, J. William Winrick. His plan is to renew the commitment to practical education at Woodbridge in Ferris made over a century ago.
Ferris will maintain its distinctive mission of training people for careers, for professions, occupations, that it does so well. And the difference will be primarily in these new occupations, new technologies. As society and technology changes, we're going to change to respond to that. The basic mission won't change at all.
Another new face is head football coach Dan Underwood. He comes fresh from shining successes as defensive assistant for Central Michigan, Michigan State, and most recently, Arizona State, where he helped coach the defensive team to the number one spot in the nation.
Really, Dan Underwood is a superb coach. He's a great guy, great human being. He's starting new first year as I am at the college. He's bringing in his own system, his own people, his own assistants. He's educating and training players in the way he wants them to do. This year we've had a heavily freshman team, got kids who are coming in for the first time with Dan. I'm really excited about what he's doing and can do.
Dan Underwood's goal for the Bulldogs is to be the best Division II team in the country. This may take some time, but he's very optimistic.
We're a very, very young program, and we're excited about the future. And we look for very, very good things to happen here.
Freshmen are vital to the football team and should expect to see some action on the field their first year at Ferris.
A young man, if he's interested in coming in and playing early, he can do that at Ferris State. And we had 54 freshmen this last fall. And we had as many as 14 start for us. So I think next year and the years to come, you're going to see freshmen and sophomores as we grow up play. So I think it's a great opportunity for a freshman to come in and play early.
Coaching staff here at Ferris is great. We had a good coaching staff the last 3 years I've been here, but for my senior year, we had a new staff come in. Dan Underwood came in from Arizona State and brought along an excellent staff with him. I think the next 3 years, the team will improve a lot, and it's a young team, and they brought in 45 recruits, and between those guys, I think they're going to have a real football dynasty in the next 3 years.
I think the programs are fine also. It's a variety of programs that you can go into. They have something for everyone.
I think the coaching staff is great. All the new coaches came in, brought a lot of freshmen in, and let everybody see what they can do and told all the players that all the jobs was open.
I like most about Ferris is that you're an individual up here and people understand you, they know you, and you're not treated like just another number like you would be at another school possibility. And it's just, you're treated as one, an individual.
I really like the coaching staff. They're really nice. They're young coaching staff, and I think they'll take us to the championship.
What I like most about Ferris is the campus life. There's a lot of activities on campus here at Ferris. You meet a lot of interesting people, and there's just a lot of things to do for you.
Our coaching staff is very enthusiastic, very excited. Always keep you pumped up and ready for the game, during season and off season.
To help build the special skills required to create a winning team, Dan Underwood brought in his own coaching assistants. Underwood believes that you win on defense. He also knows that you can't win without a good blend of running and throwing. And you can't forget the fan support. Football is an important part of Ferris State College. Athletes learn about teamwork, personal commitment, and they all reach for that common goal, success. Industry. Opportunity. Education. The ideas upon which Woodbridge and Ferris founded the institution, and 100 years later, are still the driving force behind Ferris's success, not only in the classroom, but out on the field. We'll be right back. Ferris State College, an attitude of success that started in the mind of one great man, Woodbridge N. Ferris. A former governor of Michigan and United States Senator, Ferris founded the institution 100 years ago. His intent was to provide a practical education for any person with the motivation and potential to benefit. Initially known as the Ferris Industrial School, it became the Ferris Institute at the turn of the century. In 1950, Ferris became a state college with a growing national recognition for its dedication to educational success. However, tragedy struck as fire swept through the college, consuming most of its beautiful campus and its past. But its spirit could not be quelled. From the ashes rose a new and greater commitment to success, growing at an unprecedented rate. Still located where it was founded 100 years ago in the scenic Muskegon River Valley, Ferris now boasts a new campus accommodating its over 100 career-oriented programs. Ferris's most popular school is the School of Business, boasting a wide variety of programs in business and management fields. Established nearly a century ago, Ferris's School of Pharmacy remains one of the most prestigious pharmacy schools in the Midwest. More than half of all practicing pharmacists in Michigan hail from Ferris. The newest addition to Ferris is the College of Optometry, the only such school in Michigan and one of 14 in the nation. Ferris's place at the forefront of technical education is maintained by the schools of education and technology. Career-oriented hands-on training in all of Ferris's programs produce an overall job placement rate of over 90%. This combined with student dedication has made success a tradition at Ferris for over 100 years. The 1984 centennial celebration saw the arrival of a new Ferris State College president, J. William Winrick. His plan is to renew the commitment to practical education at Woodbridge N. Ferris made over a century ago.
Ferris will maintain its distinctive mission of training people for careers, for professions, occupations, that it does so well. And the difference will be primarily in these new occupations, new technologies. As society and technology changes, we're going to change to respond to that. The basic mission won't change at all.
Another new face is head football coach Dan Underwood. He comes fresh from shining successes as defensive assistant for Central Michigan, Michigan State, and most recently, Arizona State, where he helped coach the defensive team to the number one spot in the nation.
Clearly, Dan Underwood is a superb coach. He's a great guy, great human being. He's starting new first year as I am at the college. He's bringing in his own system, his own people, his own assistants. He's educating and training players in the way he wants them to do. This year we've had a heavily freshman team, got kids who are coming in for the first time with Dan. I'm really excited about what he's doing and can do.
Dan Underwood's goal for the Bulldogs is to be the best Division II team in the country. This may take some time, but he's very optimistic.
We're a very, very young program, and we're excited about the future. And we look for very, very good things to happen here.
Freshmen are vital to the football team and should expect to see some action on the field their first year at Ferris.
A young man, if he's interested in coming in and playing early, he can do that at Ferris State. We had 54 freshmen this last fall. We had as many as 14 start for us. So I think next year and the years to come, you're going to see freshmen and sophomores as we grow up play. So I think it's a great opportunity for a freshman to come in and play early.
Coaching staff here at Ferris is great. We had a good coaching staff the last 3 years I've been here, but for my senior year we had a new staff come in. Dan Underwood came in from Arizona State and brought along an excellent, you know, staff with him. I think the next 3 years the team will improve a lot, and it's a young team, and they brought in 45 recruits, and between those guys, I think they're going to have a, you know, a real football dynasty in the next 3 years.
I think the programs are fine also. You know, it's a variety of programs that you can go into. You know, they have something for everyone.
I think the coaching staff is great. All the new coaches came in, brought a lot of freshmen in, and let everybody see what they can do, and told all the players that all the jobs was open.
I like most about Ferris is that you're an individual up here, and people understand you, they know you, and you're not treated like just another number like you would be at another school possibility. And it's just, you're treated as one, an individual.
I really like the coaching staff. They're really nice. They're young coaching staff, and I think they'll take us to the championship.
What I like most about Ferris is the campus life. There's a lot of activities on campus here at Ferris. You meet a lot of interesting people, and there's just a lot of things to do for you.
Our coaching staff is very enthusiastic, very excited. Always keep you pumped up and ready for the game. You're doing season and off season.
To help build the special skills required to create a winning team, Dan Underwood brought in his own coaching assistants. Underwood believes that you win on defense. He also knows that you can't win without a good blend of running and throwing. And you can't forget the fan support. Football is an important part of Ferris State College. Athletes learn about teamwork, personal commitment, and they all reach for that common goal, success. Industry, opportunity, education. The ideas upon which Woodbridge and Ferris founded the institution, and 100 years later, are still the driving force behind Ferris's success, not only in the classroom, but out on the field. Ferris State College, an attitude of success that started in the mind of one great man, Woodbridge N. Ferris. A former governor of Michigan and United States Senator, Ferris founded as defensive assistant for Central Michigan, Michigan State, and most recently, Arizona State, where he helped coach the defensive team to the number one spot in the nation.
Willie, Dan Underwood is a superb coach. He's a great guy, great human being. He's starting new first year as I am at the college. He's bringing in his own system, his own people, his own assistants. He's educating and training players in the way he wants them to do. This year we've had a heavily freshman team, got kids who are coming in for the first time with Dan. I'm really excited about what he's doing and can do.
Dan Underwood's goal for the Bulldogs is to be the best Division II team in the country. This may take some time, but he's very optimistic.
We're a very, very young program, and we're excited about the future. And we look for very, very good things to happen here.
Freshmen are vital to the football team and should expect to see some action on the field their first year at Ferris.
A young man, if he's interested in coming in and playing early, he can do that at Ferris State. And we had 54 freshmen this last fall. And we had as many as 14 start for us. So I think next year and the years to come, you're going to see freshmen and sophomores as we grow up play. So I think it's a great opportunity for a freshman to come in and play early.
Coaching staff here at Ferris is great. We had a good coaching staff the last 3 years I've been here, but for my senior year, we had a new staff come in. Dan Underwood came in from Arizona State and brought along an excellent, you know, staff with him. I think the next 3 years the team will improve a lot, and it's a young team, and they brought in 45 recruits, and between those guys, I think they're gonna have a, you know, a real football dynasty in the next 3 years.
I think the programs are fine. Also, you know, it's a variety of programs that you can go into. You know, they have something for everyone.
I think the coaching staff is great. All the new coaches came in, brought a lot of freshmen in, and let everybody see what they can do, and told all the players that all the jobs was open.
I like most about Ferris is that you're an individual up here, and people understand you, they know you, and you're not treated like just another number like you would be at another school possibility. And it's just, you're treated as one, an individual.
I really like the coaching staff. They're really nice. They're young coaching staff, and I think they'll take us to the championship.
What I like most about Ferris is the campus life. There's a lot of activities on campus here at Ferris. You meet a lot of interesting people, and there's just a lot of things to do for you.
Our coaching staff is very enthusiastic, very excited, always keep you pumped up and ready for the game, during season and off season.
To help build the special skills required to create a winning team, Dan Underwood brought in his own coaching assistants. Underwood believes that you win on defense. He also knows that you can't win without a good blend of running and throwing. And you can't forget the fan support. Football is an important part of Ferris State College. Athletes learn about teamwork, personal commitment, and they all reach for that common goal, success. Industry, opportunity, education. The ideas upon which Woodbridge and Ferris founded the institution, and 100 years later, are still the driving force behind Ferris's success, not only in the classroom, but out on the field. We'll be right back. Ferris State College, an attitude of success that started in the mind of one great man, Woodbridge N. Ferris. A former governor of Michigan and United States Senator, Ferris founded the institution 100 years ago. His intent was to provide a practical education for any person with the motivation and potential to benefit. Initially known as the Ferris Industrial School, it became the Ferris Institute at the turn of the century. In 1950, Ferris became a state college with a growing national recognition for its dedication to educational success. However, tragedy struck as fire swept through the college, consuming most of its beautiful campus and its past. But its spirit could not be quelled. From the ashes rose a new and greater commitment to success, growing at an unprecedented rate. Still located where it was founded 100 years ago in the scenic Muskegon River Valley, Ferris now boasts a new campus accommodating its over 100 career-oriented programs. Ferris's most popular school is the School of Business, boasting a wide variety of programs in business and management fields. Established nearly a century ago, Ferris's School of Pharmacy remains one of the most prestigious pharmacy schools in the Midwest. More than half of all practicing pharmacists in Michigan hail from Ferris. The newest addition to Ferris is the College of Optometry, the only such school in Michigan and one of 14 in the nation. Ferris's place at the forefront of technical education is maintained by the Schools of Education and Technology. Career-oriented hands-on training in all of Ferris's programs produce an overall job placement rate of over 90%. This combined with student dedication has made success a tradition at Ferris for over 100 years. The 1984 centennial celebration saw the arrival of a new Ferris State College president, J. William Winrick. His plan is to renew the commitment to practical education that Woodbridge N. Ferris made over a century ago.
Ferris will maintain its distinctive mission of training people for careers, for professions, occupations, that it does so well. And the difference will be primarily in these new occupations, new technologies. As society and technology changes, we're going to change to respond to that. The basic mission won't change at all.
Another new face is head football coach Dan Underwood. He comes fresh from shining successes as defensive assistant for Central Michigan, Michigan State, and most recently, Arizona State, where he helped coach the defensive team to the number one spot in the nation.
Clearly, Dan Underwood is a superb coach. He's a great guy, great human being. He's starting new first year as I am at the college. He's bringing in his own system, his own people, his own assistants. He's educating and training players in the way he wants them to do. This year we've had a heavily freshman team. Got kids who are coming in for the first time with Dan. I'm really excited about what he's doing and can do.
Dan Underwood's goal for the Bulldogs is to be the best Division II team in the country. This may take some time, but he's very optimistic.
We're a very, very young program, and we're excited about the future. And we look for very, very good things to happen here.
Freshmen are vital to the football team and should expect to see some action on the field their first year at Ferris.
A young man, if he's interested in coming in and playing early, he can do that at Ferris State. We had 54 freshmen this last fall. At one time, we had as many as 14 start for us. So I think next year and the years to come, you're going to see freshmen and sophomores as we grow up play. So I think it's a great opportunity for a freshman to come in and play early.
Coaching staff here at Ferris is great. We had a good coaching staff the last 3 years I've been here, but for my senior year we had a new staff come in, Dan Underwood came in from Arizona State and brought along an excellent, you know, staff with him. I think the next 3 years the team will improve a lot, and it's a young team, and they brought in 45 recruits, and between those guys, I think they're going to have a, you know, a real football dynasty in the next 3 years.
I think the programs are fine also. You know, it's a variety of programs that you can go into. You know, they have something for everyone.
I think the coaching staff is great. All the new coaches came in, brought a lot of freshmen in, and let everybody see what they can do, and told all the players that all the jobs was open.
I like most about Ferris is that you're an individual up here, and people understand you, they know you, and you're not treated like just another number like you would be at another school possibility. And it's just, you're treated as one, an individual.
I really like the coaching staff. They're really nice. They're young coaching staff, and I think they'll take us to the championship.
What I like most about Ferris is the campus life. There's a lot of activities on campus here at Ferris. You meet a lot of interesting people, and there's just a lot of things to do for you.
Our coaching staff is very enthusiastic, very excited. Always keep you pumped up and ready for the game. You're doing season and off season.
To help build the special skills required to create a winning team, Dan Underwood brought in his own coaching assistants. Underwood believes that you win on defense. He also knows that you can't win without a good blend of running and throwing.
Hello and welcome back for game three of the CCL qualifier for Call of Duty Crimson. I am once again Flash Rewinds, and this is
Broken EXE.
Welcome back. Obviously, there was a big break there. We were waiting for some games to finish up, so we knew who we were facing. We'll be facing the University of Wisconsin, so Big Ten team we're going up against. I am confident. I saw the map pool. The map pool looks pretty good for us. So
what is the map pool?
Sorry. It is, I believe, I know Skid Row, S&D.
Okay.
I know it's, Karachi, Control.
Okay.
And then I believe it's Invasion, Hardpoint. I don't know what the first Hardpoint is, but I know... I think it's, yeah, the second hard point is Invasion.
Okay.
The S&D, the first S&D is Skid Row. The Control is Karachi, and the final S&D, I believe, is also Karachi.
Okay.
I can't remember the first one. But we are going into games, so we're going to find out right now.
Exactly.
It's Karachi. Okay.
A lot of Karachi gameplay today.
I don't mind it because it seems to be one of our comfort picks, so.
Yeah. Yeah, after the, even though the score.
Oh, okay. We're in a draw. Do we win? I don't think so. But we don't lose either, so.
Yeah, I think.
Welcome back.
After, while the score doesn't say it, it was a relatively strong performance from Ferris against that St. Clair team, considering the caliber.
Despite them being, and they said they're the four best players in all of Canada.
Oh, wow.
And they have three coaches that are paid.
Wow.
So
Yeah.
They're pretty good.
A titan.
Yeah.
Really.
Really, yeah.
So in us giving a relatively strong performance against them, I do have the confidence in this Ferris team.
Yeah.
In order to pull out the win now in this match.
Yeah. I think the only team that could really contest St. Clair is Northwood.
Yeah.
And Northwood's like the goats of collegiate esports, so.
Yeah, it's like of all the games, really, it's... Yeah. Northwood is that titan.
And we're going back in. Welcome back.
Karachi.
Karachi Hardpoint. And we're back.
Let's try this one more time.
I believe we're on the right side, I would imagine. This looks like the right side. Don't quote me on that. Yes, that's Mikey's gun.
Yes.
I believe we're on... I'm going to guess airstrike. Oh, no, we're not. I don't know where we're on anymore.
Unsure.
Starting 10, so show me what you got.
So I'll be interested to see what Ferris learned from that St. Clair game.
Yeah. Oh. Another draw, I guess?
Another draw.
I got nothing. Obviously, there's some problems with whatever mode or whatever settings they have, there's some mix-up. I don't know what it is, but there's something wrong.
Yeah, probably some just like technical difficulty with the lobby.
Yeah, we'll get it figured out, and we'll be back there shortly. I expect them to just continue what they've been doing on Karachi this entire day.
Yeah.
Top thirds is going to be big, obviously. Top third is always big because it's just, it overlooks all of mid. Mm-hmm. And all of that B side, S and D side. So
yeah,
look for them. Early rotates is something we're pretty good at, so I would expect to see a lot of that. And just winning our trades. I mean, that's the name of the game is who can trade the most.
Yeah, especially on to secure that hard point.
Yeah,
so I am excited though.
Yeah, I am very confident in us winning. So.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully this starts up soon. We can start watching some gameplay, yeah?
Absolutely.
It looks like they're loading it. Oh, we had a restart.
Oh.
Yeah, someone DC'd.
That would do it. That would cause
it. I think auto DC'd. So.
That should get fixed.
Yeah. He's already loading back in right now, so.
Yeah.
We'll get that figured out. I thought it was something with the settings, but I guess someone DC'd. So, yeah, we'll get that squared away, and then we'll be right back with the action. You see Mikey, and then Airstrike and Missing Piece. They look good. I mean, I don't think they don't look distraught or anything. But
yeah.
I mean, they were just having fun at the end. They even said it. They were just trying to have fun. So.
Yeah, I think making sure you have that mental reset in order to not get that snowball mentality from that St. Clair
game
into this
one. You can't get discouraged playing a game like St. Clair.
Exactly.
Mean, yeah, like that team is just like it's like this year's Pistons going against the 16 Warriors. It's just not fair. It ain't gonna go well. So
yep. So yeah, important to just get that mental reset.
I mean, it's such a insane yeah.
Yeah, I would say it is St. Clair.
Obviously, I don't know. There might be viewers that don't know, but like everyone here is just here to be here. There's not really many scholarships or any at all. So
yeah.
They're just playing out of the love of the game and wanting to play as a team and all that. So. And that's what we try to provide is just an outlet for all these people to have fun and meet new people and have great experiences. So.
Oh, yeah. And Ferris Esports always does a great job of making sure it's school first.
Yes.
And then games.
Yes.
In esports second.
100%.
So, yeah, making with that education focus and then having these players still here competing.
Which is what should come first.
Absolutely.
Know? We're here to graduate and move on to bigger things, so.
Yeah, absolutely.
Looks like Otto is warming up, I can see in his screen. So we should be starting any minute now, I would imagine, so. Yeah.
Making sure to get back locked in?
Yeah, I mean, they look locked. They look like they're ready to go. So.
Oh, absolutely.
I don't really have much more to say. I mean, it's kind of just waiting for see if the proof's in the pudding. So, well, I guess we'll just chill. Looks like Mikey's putting in his headphones, so I believe we're about to get started.
Okay, put on his.
That's the only thing I can get from that is we're about to start. So
yeah, I think Mikey is the only person I know who uses two sets of headphones.
Do
you really?
Yes.
Really?
I use in-ear monitors, mm-hmm. and then I just have a headset for the mic.
Ah, that makes sense.
So, yeah.
I've thought about using in-ear.
Oh, they're awesome.
Are they?
Love them. Yeah. At home, I just have earbuds because I have a Yeti, so I just talk in that. So.
Yeah, because I do have a separate mic on my own thing, but I usually use headphones.
Yeah. Is there anyone you're looking at in particular? Or?
I'm interested in, of course, Otto.
Yeah.
The fragger of the team. Always making sure to find that value in the gunfights.
Yep.
Both Airstrike and Missing Piece.
Yeah.
They've been the rapid improvement that I've been seeing from them.
Yeah.
Is incredible. Because I mean seeing the struggle from last Wednesday's match and then seeing that improvement and making sure to not.
And it could have been just nerves, you never know.
Absolutely.
Like,
absolutely.
I mean, it was Airstrike's first time being on a Crimson team, so he was a little nervous. He just wanted to perform.
Yeah.
And it didn't go anybody's way, so.
Yep. So yeah, and I think the thing that I'm most curious about with this match is how well the team has mental reset.
Yes.
Going from that 0-3 loss against St. Clair. Because that can be rough. I've been in those positions where
you guys played St. Clair last year, right? Or Crimson did?
Crimson did last semester. Yeah. And it's not easy, obviously. So I'm curious to see that.
At least we're back in, so let's hope third time's a charm.
Yeah, let's see. Let's hope everything goes well. Let's not count our chickens before they hatch.
Yeah.
We have gotten here before.
So that's good.
I'll consider it on after like 3 seconds of when it starts.
Alright, we're going. We're going.
We're good.
So we're starting with Airstrike. It looks like he's just gonna jump mid and try and get time right off the bat. He's gonna look for a corner just jump where he goes. Oh, he's actually pushing up. So really what we wanna do here is number three is gonna try and take top thirds and he goes down, but that's literally the name of the hill. Is just maintaining that top hill overlook. So
yeah, I'm really glad to see the Ferris punish Honey Badger, who was on that flank, which was a very big pain point in that St. Clair match.
You can see he's going for it again. Airstrike's gonna get one, but he's gonna take it out by Honey Badger. So Wisconsin will pick up the last 15 seconds. Still, they will not actually.
Yeah.
So left with just 6 points, it looks like Wisconsin's gonna have the early rotate. Otto's just trying to look for a pick so they can start moving in. And we'll see what Ferris can do. Otto, he's gonna take down Key.
Yep, I make sure to get that trick from Mikey, which is nice.
Angle's gonna take down Missing Piece. Airstrike gets one, but he's gonna get taken down by Silent. Mikey's gonna try and go through post, I'd imagine. Yep, he's just looking for a kill. He's gonna get taken down though by Silent, so. First initial break isn't going their way. Missing Piece is gonna get one, but Angle's gonna get a trade on Otto. Airstrike flies in. He's gonna get contested, and Wisconsin is going to regain what they had, and they're probably gonna get the remaining time unless Ferris can make something of it. But it looks like we're just gonna rotate for him.
Yeah.
He's gonna get back. Should get that called out. He's looking for spawns right now. That's literally, he's just trying to get spawns right now. So if we spawn out, that's not good, but we should be able to maintain. Airstrike gets one. Yep, you see one spawned all the way back there.
Yeah.
Which is not great. Not great at all. Airstrike gonna get taken down. Otto's still back there despite us being so far away. And he's gonna get one. He's gonna break out. He's gonna get another one. That's four down for the Bulldogs. We should get the spawns. We do. Wisconsin is spawning out, so Otto with another
Otter's going absolutely insane.
Yeah, and he's got a stun. He isn't going to be able to get another one. He's going to get killed by Silent, but we are set up for this point, and we should be able to get the rest of the same time.
Yeah.
Mikey isn't going to be able to get that kill. He's going to push out, and they are able to break, but not before we get some time on it.
Yeah, say, Otter doing a really good job denying Wisconsin of more time.
Yeah.
Going out, fragging out, which is what he is best at. So really, really impressive from what we saw from him.
I like Missing Peace taking this top.
Oh, yeah.
No one top thirds, but he might be able to see that. Yeah, he is going to get that kill on Silent. So initial gain is going to be for the Ferris State Bulldogs. Missing Peace, top third. Able to get that kill on the key. We do have a flank coming in from five. That's Silent. Is going to get Mikey, and Airstrike is going to trade it. So we still maintain our thing, but Key's going to take down Airstrike. Auto takes down Key, and Auto's going to get two. Mr. Peace is going to get one, and that's four down, so we will get the remaining time.
That's a great play for Airstrike. Ooh, getting a little punch there, but making sure that we're trading out, we're playing together, and getting those cross cards down.
Airstrike's going to get taken down by Key. Mikey just looking for spawns, it looks like, at this point. It is going to go this back, the back shed, so Mikey's just trying to secure spawns. Oh, and Otto with a nasty kill. He's going to get traded, but nonetheless. And they do have spawns, so that's huge. Mm-hmm. Airstrike with a nice double. Woo! Headshots only for him as he's able to get on point and start gaining this time. 40 seconds left in the hill. A lot of good time.
Airstrike really making sure that he's showing that he belongs on this Crimson roster.
Yeah. Airstrike is going to get taken by Key. Missing Peace will get a trade, but also Angle will trade out Missing Peace. So, a lot of trades,
yeah.
A lot of switching points. It's just been back and forth. I don't know if we're going to see any. I mean, I'm waiting for someone to get one big money hill, and then it starts to really spread out. See what happens.
There it is.
They are going to get the remaining 6 seconds, or not.
No.
So they will have about a, was it, 9-point lead? Nine-point lead.
So that'll quickly
That's
flip
gonna
over.
Get, yeah, it's going to get taken out probably right now, so.
Yeah.
And, well, Key's got something to say about that, so it's Honey Badger, and they're going to get back on point. Oh, Missing Peace is going to get stuck by Key. So now, I don't know how Ferris plans to play this. I think they're going to give it another try, maybe two. And then they're going to start looking at that P2 rotate. So, Otto sitting on B-side S&D, just trying to get somebody to peek out, but he's not getting much.
Yeah, looks like they're just guarding those outs.
That's what I was saying. Wisconsin got basically a full 60 here, so interested to see if they maintain their lead or if they or if Ferris can get right back into it. Mikey gets taken out, but Airstrike is gonna trade it. They are gonna get a couple seconds on the last hill, and they'll have control of this hill from the start. Key takes down Otto. Mikey trades out Key. Airstrike just soaking hill. Mikey gets a kill on Silent. Missing Peace gets a kill on Honey Badger. That's a good first wave. Defense. Mikey takes down Angle. You see Otto's going to push up, trying to get more pressure. He's going to get shut up, but he is still alive. Meanwhile, Missing Peace does get Key. Missing Peace gets Silent as well. Otto gets Angle. That's another defense, but Mikey is going to get taken by Honey Badger, and Key's going to get Missing Peace. So here comes the Badgers. Airstrike gets one. Able to maintain that. He is going to get killed, but that's still a lot of good time that he was able to get there. About 40 seconds. And they are already on the rotate for P3, but we did get spawned out, so look for a huge gunfight to start breaking out in this P3. You see everyone's taking their time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, one player from Wisconsin staying on that hill into the last second.
He's going to get taken out. And that's two down. Mikey gets one, Airstrike gets one, so we should have spawns.
I think it was a great punch from us going into that 4v3, knowing that one player was still on that hill.
Yeah.
And now this next gunfight breaking out here.
Oh, Mikey's gonna get shadow, but he's gonna maintain his top position.
I don't frag it though.
Seven. Oh, Wisconsin breaks in.
Yeah.
He's taking down Mikey. Good trade, but it's an uphill battle from here. And Wisconsin has hit the 90-point mark, which means they can win off of any of the next hills. Theoretically.
Yes.
Because a full 60 would give them if they were just at 190, but obviously they're going to get a little bit more, so they don't need as much time. So, what will the Bulldogs think to do here? Six is trying to get into the back to get a spawns, but I'm hoping missing pieces will come out. And he is!
Good.
Airstrike is actually going to get that good coverage from him. Honey Badger is going to get Airstrike, but Otto is going to trade that out. So look for someone. I don't know who it's going to be to soak the hill. That's two for Otto. He's going to get Mikey. He's going to get Airstrike as well. Silent, that's three down for the Bulldogs. That's not looking good. And Otto is also going to get taken out. So possession of the hard point is going to be for the Badgers. And this is not looking good for the Bulldogs. Mikey's going to get bull penetration. Able to get that kill. Oh, and Honey Badger's so low, but he isn't going to be able to get the kill.
Close on it, though.
Oh, and that's good coverage from Silent, but we are able to break back into the hill. Not just yet, as Key takes down Missing Piece and Airstrike, so that is another four down for the Bulldogs, and it's a mad dash to P5, as they only need 3 seconds to win this. And that looks like it's going to be it for the Badgers. Maybe not.
Maybe not. Not if Otto has anything to say about it.
Yeah, Otto's able to get on, and that's going to be possession for the Bulldogs. But can they maintain it?
That was a great ending fight.
Yeah, it was
a good try
for the Bulldogs. Yeah. They just weren't able to convert it on that P4 to P5 rotate.
Mm-hmm.
They kept getting breaking that P4, and that was an unfortunate end to the hard point, but it was a good try.
Yeah, there are a lot of good punishes there where Wisconsin would keep one guy on for until it was like 3 seconds left on that hill.
Yeah.
And then Ferris was able to capitalize on that 4v3 and take advantageous gunfights. But sadly, just not enough. Just losing out on a few more gunfights. They were close and could have went either way.
Yeah. And you can see Otto went 22-12, I believe. And Missing Piece, I think it was, went 16-16. And that was good performances out of them. Just weren't able to capitalize on some of those 50-50 hills and didn't fall our way. But we still have a Skid Row S&D. I am very confident, despite what happened with St. Clair.
Yes.
Wisconsin is definitely a more even team with us, so obviously, we didn't get 0 points in the hard point. So
this game is, and I think that's important for the Ferris players to realize.
Yeah,
it's not. This isn't another St. Clair. This isn't looking for highlights in a very tough road ahead. This is absolutely winnable.
Yes,
we can take the series close, and we can get the win on it. We just need to regroup and get the mental into it.
In case people don't know what's on the line, if we do win this game, we do get into the Division One division. So a win here would be massive for us. If not, we go down to Division Two, which is not exactly what we want, but it is what it is, you know?
Yeah. So yeah, I'm looking forward because I think this hard point is where we're going to see that the Ferris play style really shine.
The S&D?
Yes.
Okay. I think you said hard point, but
oops.
It's fine. It is what it is.
The next map.
Yeah.
The next map.
Yeah, Skid Row is definitely a map that I think they're comfortable in. They seemed pretty happy when it made it through veto, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm excited to see what happens. It should be any time now. I mean, there's not really much break between these two maps, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't have really much to say. Otto maintaining his dominance. He's been pretty good all day, so.
Oh, yeah.
Hoping he keeps that up. Mikey's been a rock for the team, so that's good. It's good to see that Airstrike's still playing with his fly mentality. He's just flying at stuff, which is what you need. You need someone that can fly and make plays happen, create some space for the team.
Oh, so. Yeah, a missing piece really impressed me on that one.
Yeah, he's their main AR. He's really just there to post up and the take fights that are needed. So
yeah, doing a really good job of securing those gunfights and getting good trades and everything.
Yeah. S&D, obviously everyone knows, first to six, it's one life only per round, so it's you got to make sure your kills count, make sure you're not throwing lives away, so
yeah.
I'm looking to see how they decide to play. They've been pretty, their default on offense has always been, let's send three somewhere and then have missing piece in the back and just try and draw people out, so I'm looking to see if they maintain that type of play, or if they decide to make it more interesting or put some more pizzazz on it, but that seems to be their default. So
yeah, and I think missing piece really being on today, even against St. Clair, winning those 1v2s and 1v1s.
Yeah.
So I'm excited to see him really get into his own and show how good of a player he really is.
Yeah.
And then of course you have Otto and Airstrike going around fragging, and then Mikey really being that main shot caller.
Yeah.
That being able to just kind of be that calmness in the hecticness that can be in the match.
Yeah. Yeah, he's definitely their the person that keeps them going and keeps them together. So
absolutely.
Yeah, I do believe we're going in. So
awesome.
Luckily, we were able to talk about enough to get to the next map. So I believe we're starting offense or defense first, okay. But I cannot confirm nor deny that. But it does look like we are defense first. I remember that gun. I do believe we're defense first. And I was correct.
You are correct.
As I always am. No, I'm just kidding.
True.
That's not true. It's actually quite false.
It's not false if you sell it properly.
Yeah. So, as you can see, Mikey at Mr. Peace always played this left side. And Mikey does get killed by Salim. And I like that actually Missing Piece didn't go after it.
Yeah.
He decided to maintain his position. Now, usually you just go for the trade, but sometimes that's hard. And he does push out and gets punished by Honey Badger. Otto does get the trade, though, so that's good value there.
He didn't see it though, the timing.
Oh, that was such terrible timing.
1v3. Otto, we've seen Otto with these.
And he's going to get one.
That makes it a 1v2.
Very winnable. Just waiting to see what he decides to do. It looks like he is going to go up. And he is going to get silenced, so it's a 1v1. I don't think he should. He's just too low on health.
Yeah.
And he's running out of time. He had to chill, and it's just unfortunate he wasn't able to get that kill. But it was a good try.
Otto being able to show that prowess, but sadly unable to win against that 1v3. But showing that at the end of the day, this game is absolutely winnable.
Yeah, absolutely. It's definitely more chance of a win than it was with St. Clair.
Oh, absolutely. And I think it was just unfortunate with Mikey going down first.
Oh, yeah.
Super early, and then Missing Piece not being
missing
able to
piece,
follow it off.
Yeah, I would have rather him stay back, but, I mean, you got to try and get the trade, so I get it.
Yeah,
Otto is going to get seen, so look for someone to rotate. You see one's watching back.
Mm-hmm.
Back barber, so if he tries to make a move, Silent should be able to pick it up, which would spell doom for the Bulldogs.
Missing Piece watching this angle against Honey Badger, but I don't think he knows he's there.
You see 8 and 5 just trying to hold God steps.
Mm-hmm.
And they do know where Key is. At least they got some they got info on him, so that is definitely something to keep an eye on. Airstrike just trying to wait for somebody to push through.
Mm-hmm.
It's really just a waiting game. See if someone makes a mistake, but it doesn't look like that's going to be the case. And the Bulldogs are going to have to make some magic of their own. And in case you didn't know, there's only 30 seconds left, so. And he's going to get taken down, yeah.
And Mikey kills him.
Oh, Mikey is able to get the kill, so. But he's only got so much time, and he's got a plan. Yeah.
Nah.
You see some discussion comes out from Mikey. Unfortunate.
Yeah.
Yeah, I believe that was an airstrike trying to clear stairs. He didn't check his corner.
Mm-hmm.
And another round for Wisconsin.
So, yeah, I was really looking for that missing piece pinch that was going to happen.
Oh, yeah.
It
looked like he got caught out.
Yeah. Yeah, just ended up not working out for him. I like the look. I think just execution-wise, it can be cleaned up a little bit.
Yeah. Default here for the Bulldogs as missing piece and Mikey. Once again, moving towards that P3 hold. Huge snap from
good.
Mikey. What a good shot.
Yeah, amazing shot from him.
Obviously, you won't see Wisconsin going after that trade. You can see three. Who is that? Honey Badger was all the way in the back trying to beat that post. Oh, Mikey's going to take down angle because Silent got auto, so that's a good trade. Airstrike looking for something, anything. Not fighting at seven. Who is that? Missing piece. Eight. Mikey's going to see him. Should call DB. Missing piece. I think knows somebody's there. Missing piece going to take him out silent. Mikey's going to get one, and so is Airstrike, and that's going to be a round for Fair State.
Yeah, I like that. That was super clean. Not a lot of aggressive pushes.
I think Missing piece dying there was actually probably a good thing because they didn't info on the last guy, and now mm-hmm. they did. So that was a good move by Airstrike to repinch through P3.
Yeah. Yeah, no one went for the super aggressive pushes and just holding their space and then punishing anyone who tried to step forward into it.
Yeah. See, MSP should... And it's going to be a full hit.
Oh, wow.
So let's see if they can read this. Mikey is going to get Honey Badger. So that does open up the P3 push. You can see... Doesn't look like Wisconsin's biting much. They're just kind of sitting there. Airstrike is going to get value. He's not. But Mikey is going to get a trade on the key. Angle does know where they are now, but you can see one silent. He's just sitting back waiting to see if he can see anything on B. It looks like Angle's just going to go B. He doesn't even going to hold A. And that's going to punish him.
Yep.
Auto's going to get Angle, and that should be a bomb plant for the Bulldogs. As Mikey clears that, you see Silent starting to move towards God Steps, and it's going to be a 3v1. Oh, I love it.
Good.
Oh, beautiful play
punish
by Mikey just before he opens the door. And
yeah.
It's going to be another round win for the Bulldogs.
I really like the first pick from Ferris.
Yes.
In that where they all watch the same spot.
Yep.
Saw one person peek it. Three people against it, 1v3. You don't win those if you're the one.
Yeah.
So it was really nice play from that.
And
just
that
playing together.
Up half the map.
Yeah.
So
it really did.
It really was value in that pick. You see Mikey, 7-2. He's one off or he does
Ooh.
Have he has his cruise missile. So
mm-hmm.
that's gonna be good value to have in these coming rounds. Through fire again, but
Ooh.
He didn't see him. He's just gonna push way through to B.
Yeah.
And missing piece is not gonna read this. There's no way.
No, he doesn't.
So now Mikey knows that there was one coming behind him, and Mikey is gonna get taken out. At least he got his cruise missile, but yeah, this is not looking good for the Bulldogs this round. Kind of just waiting to see what happens. It looks like Wisconsin's going to plant here. And that'll start the 40-second timer.
Yep.
It's 40 seconds. 44 seconds, my bad. Airstrike does get the spot on three. So
they
now he knows
him.
There's at least one on plat.
Mm.
Oh, and almost gets the kill, but isn't able to get it. Let's see. Does Key move? No, he does not. That's going to be a round win for Wisconsin.
So, yeah, those super clean, just missing piece, not reading.
And that's hard to read. I mean, yeah, he literally flew through and just went straight to beat. Usually they'll sit and fire or something like that, but we didn't have any back there to punish them if they tried to push through.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, that was something just an unfortunate play for Ferris.
Definitely some unfortunate events for the Bulldogs.
But still, only through 3-2, and Ferris making sure to keep this game close.
Otto pushing through, looking to get some type of value out of this push. And it looks like they're deep. They're deep in. Good trade out of Otto, but he is going to get traded out by Angle. It is a 2v2 now. Mikey, sending in B. Did they hear that? No, they didn't.
No.
So he's going to get a plant off. 7 and who is that? 7 and 2? Right on top of each other.
Yeah.
So someone jumps out. And he's... they're right next to each other.
Mr. Peace knows.
What is happening?
This is
such a cluster. I was gonna see him. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's gonna be another win for Wisconsin. Yeah, he jumped right over his head.
Yeah.
Fly eagle, just didn't see him. Unfortunate.
Mm-hmm.
And that'll be another round win for Wisconsin. As we know, it is 1st to 6, so. Bulldogs need to get on their horse and start winning some of these rounds. And they're close, too. It's not like they're, like, lopsided. It's just...
Yeah. Some unfortunate timings. Some unfortunate 50-50s.
Yeah.
It's absolutely still doable.
You just gotta have your spidey senses unlock, apparently.
Yeah.
You see Mikey's gonna trick that early... move to, it looks like they switched up a bit.
Yeah, they did.
So we're gonna have 2A, 1 bottom and DVD, and then 1 out on P3 play. And that's 3 down. That's 3 down for the Bulldogs. It's not like Otto unable to get another one. And that's another one for the Bull or the Badgers.
Yeah, just isolated 1v1's not going their way.
Yeah.
Because I saw a missing piece go down.
I'm surprised P1 that. It looks like that was gonna be a win for Otto.
Yeah. Yeah, just absolute, and just wasn't able to hit that last shot, that last bullet. 5-2, match point for Wisconsin here.
Looks like we're doing another full push on P3. Otto is going to get taken down, and so is Mikey, and so is Missing Piece. It's all up to it, and it's just not going to happen. And that was just a full-on collapse by Wisconsin onto the Bulldogs, and that will be map 2 for the Badgers. Yeah, kind of unfortunate. I mean, there was a lot of like a lot of those rounds were very close, and at the end, it's just Wisconsin pulled away.
Yeah.
Was able to get a lot of value out of their pushes.
Yeah, I think what needs to happen now, Ferris just needs to take a step back.
Yeah.
Because they need to realize that a lot of those runs were close.
Yeah.
Yeah,
tough game for Missing Piece, as you can see.
Yeah. So, yeah, it's going to be a whole thing of the last couple rounds were unfortunate.
Yeah.
So they need to be able to take that step back, recollect themselves, and just be able to take a breath and then go back into control with that better mentality, make sure to keep everything positive, which I know can be difficult.
Yeah.
Especially when the last couple notes of a map weren't as you wanted them to be, as intended. But I think that's going to be vital right now.
Yeah. All right, well, we're going to hit a quick break, and we'll be back with, I believe it's Karachi Control. So we'll see you on the other side.
Established nearly a century ago,
Ferris's School of Pharmacy remains one of the most prestigious pharmacy schools in the Midwest. More than half of all practicing pharmacists in Michigan hail from Ferris. The newest addition to Ferris is the College of Optometry, the only such school in Michigan and one of 14 in the nation. Ferris's place at the forefront of technical education is maintained by the Schools of Education and Technology. Career-oriented hands-on training in all of Ferris's programs produce an overall job placement rate of over 90%. This combined with student dedication has made success a tradition at Ferris for over 100 years. The 1984 centennial celebration saw the arrival of a new Ferris State College president, J. William Winrick. His plan is to renew the commitment to practical education at Woodbridge in Ferris made over a century ago.
Ferris will maintain its distinctive mission of training people for careers, for professions, occupations, that it does so well. And the difference will be primarily in these new occupations, new technologies. As society and technology changes, we're going to change to respond to that. The basic mission won't change at all.
Another new face is head football coach Dan Underwood. He comes fresh from shining successes as defensive assistant for Central Michigan, Michigan State, and most recently, Arizona State, where he helped coach the defensive team to the number one spot in the nation.
Really, Dan Underwood is a superb coach. He's a great guy, great human being. He's starting new first year, as I am at the college. He's bringing in his own system, his own people, his own assistants. He's educating and training players in the way he wants them to do. This year we've had heavily freshman team, got kids who are coming in for the first time with Dan. I'm really excited about what he's doing and can do.
Dan Underwood's goal for the Bulldogs is to be the best Division II team in the country. This may take some time, but he's very optimistic.
We're a very, very young program, and we're excited about the future. We look for very, very good things to happen here.
Freshmen are vital to the football team and should expect to see some action on the field their first year at Ferris.
A young man, if he's interested in coming in and playing early, he can do that at Ferris State. We had 54 freshmen this last fall. We had as many as 14 start for us. So I think next year and the years to come, you're going to see freshmen and sophomores as we grow up play. So I think it's a great opportunity for a freshman to come in and play early.
Coaching staff here at Ferris is great. We had a good coaching staff the last 3 years I've been here, but for my senior year, we had a new staff come in. Dan Underwood came in from Arizona State and brought along an excellent staff with him. I think the next 3 years the team will improve a lot, and it's a young team, and they brought in 45 recruits, and between those guys I think they're going to have a real football dynasty in the next 3 years.
Is that? Oh yeah,
right,
okay.
We're alive.
Welcome back.
We're back.
We have control. Karachi, this has been a good map for us. We'll see if we can start the comeback here.
Everything's doable.
Airstrike with a kill on the angle. Honey Badger is going to get a trade, though, from Mikey. Airstrike. Oh, and it's a tight one, but Airstrike is able to get a kill. And so is Missing Piece, so that's two down.
They need to be careful of Key here. He's on the flank.
And Key's going to punish him. Mikey is going to get the trade,
though.
So it just leaves Angle in the mail. Good push up for Mikey. Oh, but dude, he like skated out of there. Yeah. That was crazy. Huge kill from
good
Otto
kill.
And Mike, or Airstrike, in order to re-stabilize. Airstrike, kind of just seeing if anyone's there, checking it, moving down to bottom red, trying to maintain that spot. Missing Piece and Airstrike are both down bottom red, trying to cut through mid, maybe trying to stop this progression. You can see 8, who's that, Otto? Or Mikey, top 8, trying to get some positioning so they can stop the A-cap.
Mm-hmm.
He's not going to be able to get it. And they should cap that, and it's going to just be it's going to be the B hit.
Yeah.
That everyone knows and loves. Honey Badger, all by himself, is going to get taken down by Missing Piece, though, so that's a huge win.
Good punish. And we're up on lives.
Yes, but they did get the B tick, so, or the A tick, so. Huge kill for Missing Piece as well. Starting off 5-0. Is going to get taken down, though. Unfortunate, but Airstrike is going to get the trade. And he's going to get another one. Oh, Mike takes down his teammate, but it is what it is, and it's all on the auto now. Otto gets one. Trying to reposition so he can get a little bit more of a better angle. But he's gonna read this. Oh, what a kill! Nice kill from Otto, and that's gonna basically cut off any reinforcements that the Badgers had, and that's gonna send them back to the drawing board.
Yeah, Missing Piece and Airstrike really make sure to clean up the point when Otto's going to punish that recontest from them.
You see Honey Badger's probably going to walk into this room. He's not going to read it. Otto isn't going to be able to get one, but he at least got, or he wasn't able to get two, but he got one. Mikey got one as well. Now he's got two. He's going to get taken down, though, by Silent. Airstrike Missing Piece, pulling down the fort. Siege coming.
Wisconsin only has 4 lives left. More respawns.
Yeah. And that's 3 down. So there's 2 lives.
2 lives. 1 life.
1 life. Airstrike.
It's all down to Honey Badger now.
Yep. That's going to be that. Good round from the Bulldogs as they're able to take down Wisconsin, hold them to just one site.
Yeah, good. Definitely a really good defense from Ferris here.
Yeah.
Make sure to play well, play good trades, and really counting on Missing Piece and Airstrike to clean up the point.
Did a lot of work there.
Yeah.
Look for on the wrong team, but look for Mikey to head to top thirds, try and maintain that top overlook so he can cap A as fast as possible.
Mm-hmm.
He's not. He's actually going to push. So looks like 7 pieces actually going to move up to top thirds.
Taking early control of the site.
See, one's pushing behind. Is that behind?
Yeah. That tick's already been got, though.
That is good value. So although we are 3 down, we did get a tick, and Otto is also in the back of their line. So look for him to make a play to try and open up something.
Oh, yeah. We've seen him do this plenty of times before, but he'll go on the flank and kill 2, 3.
Yep. That's just part of his that was an awkward fight for Airstrike, but he is going to get traded out.
The trade is important there.
Look for the spawn. Otto Otto is in their back spawn, but he did spawn him out in the back corner. I don't know if Otto's going to read this, though. They are right behind him. Yeah, and he's going to get taken out.
Yeah.
3 down for the Badgers. But Airstrike is able to kill him. That's going to get A. So that's huge for the Bulldogs.
Yeah.
Now they have to look for the Goliath called Point B.
Yeah.
But they have one down, and they're going to have back control. Yeah, that's 3 down.
Great rotation.
Airstrikes are going to just choke off this point, and he's going to send them running. That's one. Almost 2, but he isn't able to get it. But we're already got 2 ticks.
Do we get the third?
Maybe.
we
are.
We do.
Huge plays. And that was a fast cap B. They just they got caught with their pants down on that rotation of B after we capped A, and we were able to capitalize. That was good work from Airstrike to be able to choke them off on that the trash jump up,
mm-hmm.
And good job on Mikey to be able to hold point.
Yeah, because Wisconsin was like a second late to that.
Yes.
There was 3 around the point.
Yeah.
They just didn't contest it.
And some life from the Bulldogs as we go into the third round. And we had defense. Defense is the most comfortable part of this map, so could be able to close this out in a 3-0 fashion and move on to Invasion Hardpoint.
Oh, yeah.
But let's see if they can make it happen.
Yep, one step at a time here.
They are going to start controlling A, but we might actually just let them have it. save the lives.
Yeah, that might be what it's all about.
Good trade from Mikey.
happens.
Miscalculation on the trajectory of the Semtex, but that's okay.
Yep, don't worry, Mikey. No one saw it. No, it didn't happen on stream.
And he is able to get that. That's three down. That's huge.
Yeah.
And they didn't get the second tick either.
That's great play. Looks like they're working B, though.
He's going to get taken down, but Otto is there for coverage. He is going to get taken down as well. This could be a fast B hit. And I don't know if the Bulldogs are ready for it.
Yeah, they have first tick now.
Silent taking down Mikey. Yeah, this is not looking good for the Bulldogs.
Otto is on the case.
Is he able to get one? Can he get the other one, though? Well, he at least knows he's in the back.
Yep.
Oh, this is not going to be a good fight for Mikey.
But Airstrike chasing this. Airstrike getting it.
They are able to maintain it. Oh, he's coming to the back. Good trade.
Yep. Yeah. Auto. Make sure to get secure that trade.
But this is actually more dire than it seems because A is hard to hold as it is. They get the and they only have one tick on B. So if they get this A, it's only gonna take one tick for them to win this round. Airstrike is gonna get caught out and Key is gonna get Sun's gonna get Mikey. So it looks like it's all gonna come down to that one tick on B unless Auto can do something about it.
I think he's just going to be looking to get lives
he's
out
gonna
of this.
He's going to look valiant. Yep, and that's what he's going to do.
That's one.
They didn't cap it.
No, they didn't cap.
It's going to be a mad dash to A. Yeah, we're going to start taking it down.
Yeah.
That's a massive blunder by Badgers. Even though they are going to end up getting it, that's still lives they had to waste on trying to get that back.
Yeah, absolutely.
So here comes the rest. Auto gets one.
Backs out.
Angle. Yep, he's going to back out and he's going to wait for spawns.
Missing piece gets another one. Missing piece gets two.
Yeah, look how deep Auto is. Yeah, he's just holding it.
He gets two more.
He is going to get taken down, but not without punishing the Badgers.
Missing piece. Really coming into the
yeah, he's cooking right now. He's on a three streak. Honey Badger, top red. Looking for anything for his team. You can see Missing Peach just holding that male back alley. You see, here they come. The Badgers looking to make it happen. Auto gets the trade, but that's three down for the Badgers, and that's not good for the Bulldogs. Let's see if it can happen, and that's not going to happen. And that will be most likely a round win for the Badgers, despite the Bulldogs' best efforts.
So that's okay.
We're good. We're good.
Just need one. Yeah, you have some room to play with.
Yep.
And you know that at least on the final round, you're going to have defense.
We should. Oh, yeah, we will. Yeah. We got the first capture. You're right.
Yep. So no matter what, the last round, if Wisconsin wins this, you have defense. But on offense.
They need a tick here. They need at least one tick.
Okay.
They need the A point plus a tick.
Okay.
So I lied. They just full captured there. So yeah, they need full ticks, the full A, and then they need at least one tick on the B.
Which they're already on.
They are already on A, and they got two down. Mikey's gonna get taken out, but someone should take his place and start capping.
No one saw that auto. Don't worry about
fat
it.
Fat finger, but it's okay. Let's see. He's coming, but he's going to get taken down instantly by Auto. Auto's looking to cut off Church, maybe, but it looks like he's going to opt to go
missing
through
piece
the spawn.
Getting angle again.
Yeah.
There
it
pitch.
Is. And look how much time they had to waste trying to find him. I mean, we're already on our second tick, about to be three, and that's going to be the A capture. Good swing
good
from Mikey
turn.
To get then. Airstrike is also going to get a kill of his own.
And that's point?
That's it. That's point.
That's point. And we're already on
we're
B.
We're on B, too. Yeah,
we are already on there.
And it's going to be a mad dash for the Badgers, but Missing Piece is there to get one, and there should be another one for
Auto.
And Auto
gets another one, yep. Auto gets another.
Seven, who is that? Missing Piece, trying to get some top positioning. And we're still on. You're going to see the Badgers flood through this back, and they're going to get it. They got their opening.
Yeah. That's okay.
It's all right. We got a tick.
Yep, take the reset.
We're up 3 lives. This is still very winnable for the Bulldogs.
Make that 4.
Yep, up 4 lives. Otto just waiting for a call. Oh, and he almost gets that kill. He stopped shooting. Mikey unable to get the kill on Engel, but he should get the game. Well, he's going to get one. He's going to get flanked from the back.
Yeah.
So, up by 1 life now.
We did get that point and a
tick. It's tied. It's tied lives. So, what started off as a decent lead now is looking a little rough for the Bulldogs at the moment.
It almost seems like they're getting a little too antsy. They're taking
1v2s. They need to steel their nerves and try and find out a meticulous way to take this point.
Yeah. Just reset. Take the pushes. Because, I mean, as you said, B is incredibly hard.
Yes. Missy P is taken down by Silent. Look at that. Key's pushed up again.
That's unsuspecting.
Yeah, Mikey's rolling over on that one. He's not happy about it. Airstrike desperately looking for Key. He needs to try and find him. That is pushing us out, so.
Mikey, looking for it. Getting taken out by Key again. Airstrike finding
him. Good try or good coverage from Airstrike. So down 7 lives, still winnable.
Oh yeah. Because Key's
just a question of what are the Bulldogs able to do to try and break this site.
Key's going on flank again. You need to be careful of this.
That's 2. That's a huge kill from Otto. I don't think he's expecting this.
Missing P's getting key.
Back point. Yeah.
Yeah.
He's still on, Mike. He's going to get taken down, though.
Yeah.
Airstrike goes down as well. That's 1 life left for the Bulldogs. So, Otto's literally just going to try and get as many kills as possible here.
Yep.
Try and make it close. Because I think it is going to come down the lines.
Yeah, they know where he's at.
Able to get a kill.
That's okay. We got
so
the point and a tick.
Yes, I think that makes us that gives us it, but I'm not 100% sure.
I believe you, Flash. Absolutely.
I wouldn't do that. it ain't telling me. Okay, it usually tells me.
We'll see.
I guess we'll just find out.
Switching sides.
It just says that. It doesn't always mean. And we're on attack.
Malik.
Oh, no, we're not. We're on defense.
Okay.
Sorry, we're looking at Wisconsin. Okay.
Yes.
I was like, huh? So I was right. I know what
I
got.
Yes. You know what you're doing.
Kinda. I half know what I'm doing.
Hey, that's more than I know.
Fair enough. So you can see 6 auto. Already in their back spawn. Already trying to make as much of a thorn in the side as they can. And so is 2. Who is that? Key? Angle. Angle already in our spawn. So it's a battle of the spawn. As Mr. Keys gets 1, he is looking at the other one. He is not. So early ticks on for the Badgers on A. And it does look like they are going to camp it unless the Bulldogs have something to say about it. Airstrike is taken down. Mikey's going to get angled up. You can see Badger starting to move through bottom red.
Sound tag, sound
tick,
good.
But Otto's able to cover it. He gets taken down. Airstrike gets the trade.
That should give us enough time.
So A is down, so it's all down to the B site. Let's see if the Bulldogs can make it happen. Airstrike does get taken down. Otto gets angle.
They need to be careful here. No one's like...
Huge kill from Mike. Ooh. He's got to reposition. He's low. He's so low. But we are able to maintain our control of the diner. So let's see if we can have it. A 2-prong attack through back alley. Mikey gets taken down. And 2 stack. That's 2 on. It's not looking good for the Bulldogs. Airstrike gets 1.
Airstrike making it possible.
Gonna be 1v1. Airstrike's able to get it, and there's another one. He's not done yet. in the closet. He's going to wrap around, but it looks like he does get taken out. Angle gets one on Mikey, but he is taken out by Otto. 15 to 17 lives. Ferris holds lives right now, but with a minute and 30 seconds left, anything can happen. Otto gets one, but is traded up by Honey Badger. He gets one on Angle. They're just trying to hold whatever they can. I mean, this is—it's just wave after wave of the opposition, and SMP is doing his best he can to cover this whole middle area. He's gonna get one with his green missile. He is taken down. Angle. Key gets the trade. Honey Badger does take down airstrike, and it's all on to Otto.
You've seen him win these.
Yes, Key gets one. So now it's just it's 4v1 on the site. And they're all going to fly through. Otto gets one. He's just trying to buy time. Oh, whoa! And he gets the kill on Honey Badger. That's a huge win. There's still one on the site, though. He is going to take it out. Key gets Otto. So now the Badger's going to try and collapse on the point. Honey Badger gets one. Oh, no. SCP isn't able to get the kill, but we got two coming through. Dumpster. Angle or airstrike is able to get one. Here comes Otto again. And he's just not able to get it, but he does get the kill on the airstrike gets killed on Honey Badger. Angle kills Mikey, Mr. Peace gets killed, and airstrike gets killed, and that will be the game.
Yep.
Unfortunate for the Bulldogs.
Put up a really good fight though.
Yep. They're just unable to get that. A lot of close rounds. It's just comes down to the late push from the Badgers.
Yeah, they just had so much time to push into P.
Yeah. Otto, 38-22. Great game from him. Airstrike. I mean, everyone played well.
Yeah.
I mean, it wasn't even like it was like, you know, Otto was 6,000 damage. I didn't even see that. That's insane.
Yeah.
Otto's that's a lot of damage. Oh. I don't know if that's right. Okay, here we are. Still trying to learn the board. Everything's kind of wonky right now, so we're just trying to get sorted. But yeah, unfortunate end. We will be moving to D2, I believe, in the CCL. So it is what it is. We'll just have to put on a smoke show down there then.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. I have full faith in this team in order to really make
excel.
Yeah, really excel in that D2 area.
Yeah,
because I mean we took St. Clair, got a point off of them.
Yeah,
which is great.
Something. It's
yeah,
something.
It is something. Against number two in all around, and then we took Wisconsin super close.
Yep.
So D2 shouldn't be too much of an issue for us.
Yeah.
But really, really close games.
Yeah.
All around for on this Wisconsin front.
But, yeah, that's all we have for you today. Catch us, I believe, Monday for Ferris State Crimson Valorant.
Yes.
I don't know who they're playing, but they will be playing this week. So catch them. Until then, we'll see you next time. And have a good day and a weekend.
Have a great day.
He's educating and training players in the way he wants them to do. This year we've had heavily freshman team, got kids who are coming for the first time with Dan. And I'm really excited about what he's doing and can do.
Dan Underwood's goal for the Bulldogs is to be the best Division II team in the country. This may take some time, but he's very optimistic.
We're a very, very young program, and we're excited about the future. And we look for very, very good things to happen here.
Freshmen are vital to the football team and should expect to see some action on the field their first year at Ferris.
A young man, if he's interested in coming in and playing early, he can do that at Ferris State. And, we're looking, we had 54 freshmen this last fall. And we had as many as 14 starred for us. So I think next year and the years to come, you're gonna see freshmen and sophomores as we grow up play. So I think it's a great opportunity for a freshman to come in and play early.
Coaching staff here at Ferris is great. We had a good coaching staff the last 3 years I've been here, but for my senior year, we had a new staff come in. Dan Underwood came in from Arizona State and brought along an excellent, you know, staff with him. I think the next 3 years, the team will improve a lot, and it's a young team, and they brought in 45 recruits, and between those guys, I think they're going to have a, you know, a real football dynasty in the next 3 years.
I think the programs are fine also. You know, it's a variety of programs that you can go into. You know, they have something for everyone.
I think the coaching staff is great. All the new coaches came in, brought a lot of freshmen in, and let everybody see what they can do, and told all the players that all the jobs was open.
I like most about Ferris is that you're an individual up here and people understand you, they know you, and you're not treated like just another number like you would be at another school possibility. And it's just, you're treated as one, an individual.
I really like the coaching staff. They're really nice. They're young coaching staff, and I think they'll take us to the championship.
What I like most about Ferris is the campus life. There's a lot of activities on campus here at Ferris. You meet a lot of interesting people, and there's just a lot of things to do for you.
Our coaching staff is very enthusiastic, very excited, always keep you pumped up and ready for the game, from during season and off season.
To help build the special skills required to create a winning team, Dan Underwood brought in his own coaching assistants. Underwood believes that you win on defense. He also knows that you can't win without a good blend of running and throwing. And you can't forget the fan support. Football is an important part of Ferris State College. Athletes learn about teamwork, personal commitment, and they all reach for that common goal, success. Industry, opportunity, education. The ideas upon which Woodbridge and Ferris founded the institution, and 100 years later, are still the driving force behind Ferris's success, not only in the classroom, but out on the field. Thank you. Ferris State College, an attitude of success that started in the mind of one great man, Woodbridge N. Ferris. A former governor of Michigan and United States Senator, Ferris founded the institution 100 years ago. His intent was to provide a practical education for any person with the motivation and potential to benefit. Initially known as the Ferris Industrial School, it became the Ferris Institute at the turn of the century. In 1950, Ferris became a state college with a growing national recognition for its dedication to educational success. However, tragedy struck as fire swept through the college, consuming most of its beautiful campus and its past. But its spirit could not be quelled. From the ashes rose a new and greater commitment to success, growing at an unprecedented rate. Still located where it was founded 100 years ago in the scenic Muskegon River Valley, Ferris now boasts a new campus accommodating its over 100 career-oriented programs. Ferris's most popular school is the School of Business, boasting a wide variety of programs in business and management fields. Established nearly a century ago, Ferris's School of Pharmacy remains one of the most prestigious pharmacy schools in the Midwest. More than half of all practicing pharmacists in Michigan hail from Ferris. The newest addition to Ferris is the College of Optometry, the only such school in Michigan and one of 14 in the nation. Ferris's place at the forefront of technical education is maintained by the Schools of Education and Technology. Career-oriented hands-on training in all of Ferris's programs produce an overall job placement rate of over 90%. This combined with student dedication has made success a tradition at Ferris for over 100 years. The 1984 centennial celebration saw the arrival of a new Ferris State College president, J. William Winrick. His plan is to renew the commitment to practical education that Woodbridge N. Ferris made over a century ago.
Ferris will maintain its distinctive mission of training people for careers, for professions, occupations, that it does so well. And the difference will be primarily in these new occupations, new technologies. As society and technology changes, we're going to change to respond to that. The basic mission won't change at all.
Another new face is head football coach Dan Underwood. He comes fresh from shining successes as defensive assistant for Central Michigan, Michigan State, and most recently, Arizona State, where he helped coach the defensive team to the number one spot in the nation.
Really, Dan Underwood is a superb coach. He's a great guy, great human being. He's starting new first year as I am at the college. He's bringing in his own system, his own people, his own assistants. He's educating and training players in the way he wants them to do. This year we've had a heavily freshman team. Got kids who are coming in for the first time with Dan. I'm really excited about what he's doing and can do.
Dan Underwood's goal for the Bulldogs is to be the best Division II team in the country. This may take some time, but he's very optimistic.
We're a very, very young program, and we're excited about the future. And we look for very, very good things to happen here.
Freshmen are vital to the football team and should expect to see some action on the field their first year at Ferris.
A young man, if he's interested in coming in and playing early, he can do that at Ferris State. We had 54 freshmen this last fall. At one time, we had as many as 14 start for us. So I think next year and the years to come, you're going to see freshmen and sophomores as we grow up play. So I think it's a great opportunity for a freshman to come in and play early.
Coaching staff here at Ferris is great. We had a good coaching staff the last 3 years I've been here, but for my senior year, we had a new staff come in. Dan Underwood came in from Arizona State and brought along an excellent, you know, staff with him. I think the next 3 years the team will improve a lot, and it's a young team, and they brought in 45 recruits, and between those guys, I think they're gonna have a, you know, a real football dynasty in the next 3 years.
I think the programs are fine. Also, you know, it's a variety of programs that you can go into. You know, they have something for everyone.
I think the coaching staff is great. All the new coaches came in, brought a lot of freshmen in, and let everybody see what they can do, and told all the players that all the jobs was open.
I like most about Ferris is that you're an individual up here and people understand you, they know you, and you're not treated like just another number like you would be at another school possibility. And it's just, you're treated as one, an individual.
I really like the coaching staff. They're really nice. They're young coaching staff, and I think they'll take us to the championship.
What I like most about Ferris is the campus life. There's a lot of activities on campus here at Ferris. You meet a lot of interesting people, and there's just a lot of things to do for you.
Our coaching staff is very enthusiastic, very excited. Always keep you pumped up and ready for the game, even during season and off season.
To help build the special skills required to create a winning team, Dan Underwood brought in his own coaching assistants. Underwood believes that you win on defense. He also knows that you can't win without a good blend of running and throwing. And you can't forget the fan support. Football is an important part of Ferris State College. Athletes learn about teamwork, personal commitment, and they all reach for that common goal, success. Industry. Opportunity. Education. The ideas upon which Woodbridge and Ferris founded the institution, and 100 years later, are still the driving force behind Ferris's success, not only in the classroom, but out on the field. Thank you. Ferris State College, an attitude of success that started in the mind of one great man, Woodbridge N. Ferris. A former governor of Michigan and United States Senator, Ferris founded the institution 100 years ago. His intent was to provide a practical education for any person with the motivation and potential to benefit. Initially known as the Ferris Industrial School, it became the Ferris Institute at the turn of the century. In 1950, Ferris became a state college with a growing national recognition for its dedication to educational success. However, tragedy struck as fire swept through the college, consuming most of its beautiful campus and its past. But its spirit could not be quelled. From the ashes rose a new and greater commitment to success, growing at an unprecedented rate. Still located where it was founded 100 years ago in the scenic Muskegon River Valley, Ferris now boasts a new campus accommodating its over 100 career-oriented programs. Ferris's most popular school is the School of Business, boasting a wide variety of programs in business and management fields. Established nearly a century ago, Ferris's School of Pharmacy remains one of the most prestigious pharmacy schools in the Midwest. More than half of all practicing pharmacists in Michigan hail from Ferris. The newest addition to Ferris is the College of Optometry, the only such school in Michigan and one of 14 in the nation. Ferris's place at the forefront of technical education is maintained by the Schools of Education and Technology. Career-oriented hands-on training in all of Ferris's programs produce an overall job placement rate of over 90%. This combined with student dedication has made success a tradition at Ferris for over 100 years. The 1984 centennial celebration saw the arrival of a new Ferris State College president, J. William Winrick. His plan is to renew the commitment to practical education at Woodbridge N. Ferris made over a century ago.
Ferris will maintain its distinctive mission of training people for careers, for professions, occupations, that it does so well. And the difference will be primarily in these new occupations, new technologies. As society and technology changes, we're going to change to respond to that. The basic mission won't change at all.
Another new face is head football coach Dan Underwood. He comes fresh from shining successes as defensive assistant for Central Michigan, Michigan State, and most recently, Arizona State, where he helped coach the defensive team to the number one spot in the nation.
Clearly, Dan Underwood is a superb coach. He's a great guy, great human being. He's starting new first year, as I am at the college. He's bringing in his own system, his own people, his own assistants. He's educating and training players in the way he wants them to do. This year, we've had heavily freshman team. Got kids who are coming in for the first time with Dan. I'm really excited about what he's doing and can do.
Dan Underwood's goal for the Bulldogs is to be the best Division II team in the country. This may take some time, but he's very optimistic.
We're a very, very young program, and we're excited about the future. And we look for very, very good things to happen here.
Freshmen are vital to the football team and should expect to see some action on the field their first year at Ferris.
A young man, if he's interested in coming in and playing early, he can do that at Ferris State. And we had 54 freshmen this last fall. And we had as many as 14 start for us. So I think next year and the years to come, you're going to see freshmen and sophomores as we grow up play. So I think it's a great opportunity for a freshman to come in and play early.
Coaching staff here at Ferris is great. We had a